Hey guys, I figured I would do some sort of audio intro for the new Dragon Age footage. Since I'm streaming and I don't usually be like, oh hey, welcome to the next video, you know, but it's nice to have an intro type thing, so I'm gonna say, welcome to the next Dragon Age video. I hope you're enjoying it. Hopefully if there's any edits people ask me to make, I've been able to make them, and we're gonna hop right back in, so thanks, I'll see you in a minute. Okay, now we're back. Now we're back 100%. No, I'm not talking to you, Meriden. We're back. Hi. Sorry, guys. That was weird. That was odd. Meriden just wants a chat. Is she? Oh, is she just... Because I thought she was wanting to, like, give me a quest, and I was like, I don't feel like it. We'll talk to Meriden. Why is she lonely? Cole is solid now. They should chat! Oh, Josephine.
I was hoping you'd be by. We've received letters from Archon Redanus of Tevinter.
I'm sorry, it's been a while. I'm terribly sorry.
For both monarchs to come to us is nearly unheard of.
I'm not sure.
I assume that means they both want something very badly from us.
You're quite correct. Archon Redanus requests that the Inquisition, as a neutral party, destroy a Venatori cult on the Nevarran Tevinter border. King Marcus asks the same, but demands we pledge allegiance to Nevarra instead of Tevinter.
What?
What sort of man is the King of Nevarra?
At this point,
we're not pledging allegiance to anybody.
Many fear his health will soon fail him. Still, he is a Pentecost. Their dynasty is exceptionally strong.
That's right. She does. She's just lonely and has to think up a rhyme. Poor Meriden.
Pentecost. Will Cassandra be upset if we don't help her relatives?
With all respect to Sigar Pentecost, her interest in politics is best described as thin.
Thin.
Why is the ruler of Tevinter turning on the Venatori?
He has little reason to love them. Archon Redanus has rightly identified Corifia.
That's true. Lavellin isn't easy to ride. Yeah, it's true.
Tell me about Rudolph.
Wait.
Like most Tevinter.
Oh, okay.
He's heir to an ancient bloodline, politically shrewd, and a highly skilled mage. Rumor also claims he has an incredibly soft spot for cats.
Aw, cute.
What course of action would you take if you were in my place?
Strained as their relationship with Orla is, I would assist the Imperium. Their friendship is difficult to win, and Marcus is a fading power. Tevinter is the longer, richer game.
Okay. Lavellin, Dovahkiin. That would work. Perfect. I feel bad. I hope. Apparently, the Ethernet cable I have, I need to, like, figure out a way to better attach it so it doesn't come and trip people. I've been worried about that. I hope it didn't, like, hurt the router or anything.
Tell the Archon the Inquisition will do Tevinter the favor of wiping out the Venatori.
We don't need to pledge allegiance to anybody.
Very good, Inquisitor. We'll inform him at once.
But it's just like, they both want the same thing, but they want it done in their names. You know what I mean? It's close enough that Eminem would use it in a rap. Yep. It just has to be close enough, you know? It doesn't have to be perfect, according to modern rap. Oh shoot, we have an Inquisition perk. What do I want? Jeez, I could get True Grit. That might be nice. Secrets, but I don't really care. Nobility. Ooh, rare stocks might be good. No allegiances, only send army. Cutting, Ka'avimo cutting, okay. That was, okay, I was thinking about getting that one. I was. Because, but I figure it's just, it's so late in the game, but not the inventory. Is it you, Lemon Z, who thinks it's basically useless? Yeah. I already got one upgrade on the inventory, so Alliances. Oh, and we have the Solus one over here. The experiment was a success, and these readings are remarkable. By overlaying the relative strength of the Veil over maps of Orlane, Ferald and I have extrapolated points where small rifts are more likely to develop. This should let us deploy Inquisition more wisely, Inquisition forces more wisely, while still protecting people who would otherwise be threatened by demons. In addition, I have located one node of possible interest in the Hinterlands, a very large rift that has not yet been opened. It might be worth investigating the area. Thank you, Solus! What was your real purpose in having us do that?
My sister just brought me pumpkin pie! Are you watching in the other room? Aw, you sweetheart. Thank you!
You're welcome.
Oh, pumpkin pie, pumpkin pie, pumpkin, pumpkin, pumpkin pie. You and Frog Raider are the anti-inventory upgrades? Yeah. It's more than enough if you sell it you don't need regularly. But Lemon Z, but Lemon Z, you don't understand. you gotta keep things forever and ever and ever.
Store the port on the Storm Coast. Oh. Okay.
thank you, small squirrel.
The Templar's holding the Storm Coast, once a working port. Oh, this is the Blades thing! You can hardly expect a bustling trade center, but since we've established a presence in both Frozen and Orlando, our catches of the Waking Sea could prove useful. Of course, the Blades of Sarium will refuse to help unless word comes from the Herald of Andraste. We can send some of our workers to assist the Blades of Assyrian, or yes. You can arrange for additional assistance from nearby cities. Well, looks like Josephine's is the best for that. Oh, Seshu! Bye! I hope I got to say bye before you left. Let's see.
Pumpkin, pumpkin pie, pumpkin pie. Pumpkin, pumpkin pie.
Crew of adventurers! He seems driven to match the investment made in the group thus far. The goal is rambling, but has potential. A small group is certainly better suited to ferreting out whatever misplaced city, horror field tomb, or borderland he can't keep he's looking to scout. They'll have the context to do the work they're good at. Commit to recovery. Best to let them work, not get soldiers in their way. They'll have paths to where they need it. The rest is rightfully up to them. I might do it Leliana's way. But I want to go talk to Sutherland first. I think Talon is a bit more practical, and so I feel like getting practical things back would be of more benefit than the political machinations. But he's also very shrewd. So maybe this would be helpful in his cause, you know what I mean? And I've done the Cullen one before. I'd like to do the Leliana or the bleh. The Josephine one. Oh, restoring Michael Deschevins. Oh, Wade is so great. I love Wade. But last time I feel like I didn't get a lot of stuff from him, like I was expecting, but I don't know. Congratulations, his prowess as a warrior is matched only by his virtue. By preening, courtiers could stand to learn something from him. And if he desires to return to court, I would welcome him. His feud was with Celine, not him. Here's my offer, Sir Mikael. Accept it. His past transgressions will be forgotten. He'll be reinstated as Chevalier and given a place in my honor guard. Another note was appended, written in Leliana's hand. Michael's allegiance is to Orlea above all. Trust that Gaspardo sent a similar letter to Michael himself. If we keep him here, the thought that it is the Inquisition holding him back will be planted in his mind. We let Michael go. Gaspard gains a Chevalier and applause for his mercy. Gaspard wins. Michael stays with us. Gaspard turns in resentful and gains a spy. Gaspard wins yet again. Tread carefully. Oh, shoot. Okay, let's see. Well, this is wonderful news. Michael will be delighted. I believe that allowing him to return to the Imperial Court will cement the alliance between the Inquisition and the new Emperor. Gaspard wishes an advantage over the Inquisition. Let us give him one. Let Michael go and feed him believable lies about our operations. Gaspard dances to our refrain, all the while thinking he has the upper hand. We can't lose Michael. He's a valuable asset to the Inquisition. With Orlais stable for now, the Inquisition's needs come first. Besides, I do not believe Michael has great love for Gaspard. That's my thing. Is that I don't think Michael likes... I know Michael doesn't like Gaspard. So I'm unsure what to do at this point. All that glitters, that's right. We'll get that one done. We'll just do small ones for now. Alliances. Let's just do Leliana on that one. I gotta go talk to Sutherland. Sutherland, This was one of my favorite things about the game when I first played. And I noticed, and I was like really excited about, was the Sutherland thing. I think that was pure genius on BioWare's part to include that. It allows you to have a little bit more, I don't know, empathy? Oh, he's not back. Dang it. All right, Meridim. Hold up, we gotta listen to the song. It's my favorite. Well, find the powerful rift. I want to find the powerful rift really quick. Holy crap, what? That's right, that's a Solas thing. Let's do it. No, do the easy way out. get the thing the easy way. Where is it? Was it in the Hinterlands? Okay, I love the Hinterlands. I really do. I'm weird. We'll bring Dorian and... That's right! Blackwall's gone! If I don't go get Blackwall, will I be in trouble right now? Okay, hold up. Let's throw down a save. And then I'm gonna go. Give him time to brood? Okay, let me see. We'll give him time to be Broody McBroodster. It's okay. I won't lie to you guys. I am romancing Blackwall with my human female, and I am in love with him. I am just, oh my gosh, I can't even handle it. When does Solas's card change? Is it after this? Let's bring Cassandra. Yeah. Oh, there you go. Or go and do the first bit and then let Blackwall sit and have a good think about what he's done. Yeah. I really want so many games, but like, where's my money at, though? Oh, man. I know, Ashley. I want to play Battlefield. I want to play Titanfall. I've heard both those games are like really, really good for multiplayer games, like multiplayer focused games. And oh, that's right. I gave Solas the cool hat. Blackwall is the best. Blackwall is the best. Well, okay. I don't know. I really love his romance. Like, I didn't think it's sharply contesting for number one. Like, that's how much I've enjoyed it. Because for me, it is Solas's romance story in a way. Where Blackwall did something basically unforgivable. Blackwall did something unforgivable in his past. So did Solas. But the major, major, major difference between Blackwall and Solas' romance is that the redemption arc for Blackwall and the romance happens in this game. Like, you can encourage Blackwall towards redemption, which is fine, which is great. Or you can encourage him to pay the price, to basically pay the ultimate price. So you can do that. So you have that little horror story wrapped up right there, in a way. Like, and if you do the redemption way, then you can have the redemption. Plus, if you're romancing him, you can either choose to continue the romance or not. Like, and I just saw something moving in there. Freaking, that was a ram that scared the crap out of me. I don't know. It's like the personal redemption arc, but also the romantic redemption arc, where you have it is in your power to determine whether or not you're going to try to start over or keep going, or start over or stop the relationship. It's not in Solas's hands. You know what I mean? You really dislike Blackwall? No, man. I don't know. I really liked Blackwall even when I first played. Like he was a close contender for romance. But then when I finally actually did a romance with him, I have enjoyed it so much. So much. Like, the way, like, he asks, like, when he, like, asks for your forgiveness, and he's like, I know I have no, you know, I'm not deserving of this. He's like, but would you give me another chance, you know? And you can say yes or no. And I understand, I think, though he was an idiot for not going to the wardens after the real Blackwall died, I do agree with that. He should have just gone to the wardens, really. But then he wouldn't have met him, maybe, you know? Ooh, buddy! Jumpy, 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 jump! No, not that way! What the heck? Why? Okay, are you guys coming? Quickly, 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 quickly. I was in stealth, I realize now. Holy crap, these guys are not taking... Oh, crap. Ooh, buddy. Go away. Go away. You like Blackwall? Although you need to have your Canary Mage break up with him. Yep, yep, yep. Because that's gonna give you that. Holy crap! Nope, I jumped away. I jumped away. You can't get me. Oh crap! No, die, 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 die! Okay, good. Ooh, I did not realize. Oh my gosh, there's another one over there. Go away. Go away, go away, go away. Back up. Oh, nice, Dorian. Oh, Dorian, you're gonna get smacked by the Fane. Woo, we did it! Holy crap. Holy crap. Like, the wardens are gonna turn down a professional soldier. He might actually be dead by now, and he would have actually, like, he wouldn't have been able to help us at all, because he would have been having the same problem. You were neutral about him, but every playthrough you like him less and less. As a veteran, Blackwall is the thing that pisses you off the most, stolen valor. I can see that. I mean, I can respect why people don't like him. Like, I can completely understand, because he did unforgivable things. He did a horrible thing. He did several horrible things. Like, he not only did he betray his men who trusted him implicitly, like he Oh, I need to get the thing. He stole valor, like you said. Like, he took credit that was not his to have. Like, he took Blackwall's memory. And, like, he says he does it for a good reason, you know, so that the world won't lose a good man. But the world did lose a good man, you know? Like, taking his name isn't gonna change that. But it did remind him of the person he wanted to be. Superb frost rune, nice. Well, I hope you're happy, Solas. Your Kunari knows all the major spells, like Stormcage, Blizzard, and Firewall. And with Pull of the Abyss, it's like fireworks all over the field. Wow, that sounds amazing. I know, the magic in this game is awesome. I love it. I think it's... Oh, hey, chest. I think it's great. I love all the magic effects that go flying around. I don't want that. How wide is this room? Jeez. No, I can totally... I understand why. Block... Yeah, no. It's like Solas. There are people who really like Solas. And then there are people... Who is speaking? You guys, seriously, you're just camping out in here, right? You're just camping out in this elven ruin. Wait, did I see something? No. But there are people who like Solas, people who are neutral about Solas, people who dislike Solas. And everybody has good reasons for why. I think that's great. These characters are so multifaceted that people can, like, see different parts in them. Like I don't know. Oopsie. Dang it, dang it, dang it. Is that a fox again? It is a fox. I feel really bad. but we're not gonna kill it, so that's okay. No, but I like that these characters are so complex that people can, it's not just like, oh, here's how this character is, done, moving on. And everybody sees them the same way. Everybody sees them a little bit differently, and I enjoy that a lot. Makes for interesting discussions, makes for interesting character. You may be addicted. Actually, Ashley, I've been having, like, dreams about the Andromeda character creator. I'm really... I wish I could just see the Andromeda character creation screen. Because I really want to know what we're going to be able to do. And that is what I've been dreaming of for the last, like, couple of months. Let's see if I can remember how to play this game still. I keep trying to do Skyrim controls. Where was Liliana's? Not on the last temple, gentlemen. Okie dokie, let's go! Even people, like, I know, from what I've heard anyway, Vivian gets a lot of, flack, I guess? I don't know. But she's an extremely complex, and I didn't like her at first either, but in subsequent playthroughs, I more and more come to like her. And respect her, you know?
It's just as I remember it.
You didn't tell me you'd been here before.
After the Blight ended, I came here to see Justinia. She was just Dorothea then, a revered mother. I needed her wisdom after the hero of Ferelden died.
Ah, that's gonna be very interesting for when my hero is still alive! Kayuk is a witch, but you love her. Yep. Oh yeah. She is. She's fierce. She is a fierce, strong, independent woman who is just... She knows what she's about, you know? I respect that. Ashley, I'm super afraid to mess with cheekbones and chin, like jaw structure. I'm super afraid because I always mess it up. It's too quiet for comfort.
I didn't expect it to be so deserted. Makes me uneasy.
It's a small village, and it's too early for the chant. I'm sure the sisters are somewhere.
Liliana, is that you?
Sister Natalie, what are you doing here? I thought you were in Valrayo.
No, I've been here since Justinia died. This place...
Ah!
Like she's still with us.
Inquisitor, this is Natalie. A trusted friend.
Wait, Inquisitor? You brought the Inquisitor here?
This girl is very pretty.
Forgive me for not recognizing you earlier.
I wish more people would fail to recognize me.
Oh, I see.
Natalie, listen. There is something hidden here. Something Justinia left for me.
Oh,
she is disciplined and ambitious, Vivian? Yes.
I don't know, but we'll find it. I'm curious to see what brought us all here. Came with instructions for me. They were a little cryptic. Always remember that faith sprung from a barren branch. That light has no fear of darkness. Above all, that strength lives in an open heart.
She must be hinting at something in here. Let's look around.
Do they still sing verses from the benedictions every Friday?
I don't care is the funniest response. Dang it! I was actually gonna do that one.
Of course. We'd never give up the traditions of our most beloved divine.
That is lovely to hear.
Uh-oh.
I stare up at the bridge sometimes. It's terrifying, but beautiful in its way.
It is beautiful.
Have you seen it by sunrise?
When the sun rises.
Yo, she's playing you.
Enemies are making their move, vying for position, and the sunburst throne.
I don't want to. Ah. Oh, that's right. It's a painting thing.
I was in the cloister in
one knew what was going to happen, whether we would live or die. And then one morning, I found a
similar rose bush. I remember Alistair said that something about that, like, similar to a rose as well. Was it the dying branch, heart, no, open palm, and move, traitor? Oh, Stonesmith? Yes, I agree. The first time I actually, the first time I did play this, I did, oh, there's the clues. I did actually, try to figure it out without doing the glowing thing, because it just seemed like such cheating, but I did solve it, so I'm like, yeah, it's all good. Above all, the light has no fear of darkness. We'll try to do it that way, though, because yeah, it does feel like it's totally cheating otherwise. I do wish sometimes in games, when you have puzzles or riddles to solve, they wouldn't try to make it like immediately easy for you. Light has no fear of darkness. Strength lies in an open heart. Is it this one? Yeah. And then... Yep. She's sweet in origins, but no, you like her as a jaded. Yeah, mm-hmm. Yeah, I don't know. I can't... I don't know if in my canon playthrough if I'm gonna have her be hardened or not, but her and Talon got along really well, and both of them are a bit harder than Erica was. I feel like Leliana became hardened because Erica was maybe in some ways too soft and Leliana picked up the slack. But for Talon and Leliana, they basically encouraged each other to be a bit tougher. You know what I mean? Is it this or is it, I mean, is it one of these? No? Light has no fear of darkness. It's like right here. Where is it? There it is. I clicked it. Oh, she is, like, playing this girl. Oh, man, this just makes me nervous. Kayuk, my first time playing, I accidentally made Leliana hardened. I didn't know I did, and I got to this point, and I was like, oh, my gosh, like, what happens later? I was, like, totally freaked out. I was totally freaked out. I was like, oh, my gosh, this is scary. Open sesame. A rose. Uh-oh.
Sorry to keep you waiting.
Finally. I was getting tired of all these tricks.
They never sing the benedictions here on Fridays, Natalie. Something so simple. And you got it so wrong. I wanted to believe, but you were lying from the start. Keep that pretty mouth shut if you must, dear. You've already told me everything I need to know. The prickleweed burrs on your hem, talking about the sun rising through the breach. It all points to a single place. Morel in the Dales, Grand Cleric Victoire's bastion.
Whoa!
She sent you, didn't she? Victoire was always an opportunist.
Leliana is scary! The door is cool. The art is fantastic. I have to say, there's one thing about the Chantry is that they do fantastic, sort of a minimalist art style, and I love it. Andraste is always depicted, and I love the one where she's like leaping through the air. Like, it's great. They do a really good job. I don't know, man. Talon's definitely a bit harder, tough. Like, not tougher, but like blunt, but also like he's got cold eyes for a reason, you know, like they warm up on occasion, but he's in many ways he's cold in some ways.
Who is this grand cleric? I've never heard of her.
An experienced cleric. She never agreed with Justinia, but kept her ideas to herself. I suppose now with Justinia dead, she thought she could make her move.
I want to know what this grand cleric planned here.
She sent Natalie here to see what Justinia was hiding, no?
The Inquisition has turned Thidas away from the true Chantry. It must be stopped.
Stop us? You must be joking.
Mother Victoire is well loved by many. The Inquisition has more enemies than you know.
And Victoire thinks she can ally with them.
Good work. We know the name of our enemy. That's half the battle won.
Exactly.
Oh, see? They get along really well.
I'm afraid to die for my beliefs. At least I still know what I believe.
I don't know if he would be up for killing her, though. I don't know. Killer? Spare her. Alright, let's now keep... Give me options, guys. Like, let's see. I've got one for one. I think last time I asked her to spare her, but I think she dies either way. But I'm just trying to think, because Erica is kinder than Talon is. Kill, kill, kill. Faithful Leliana, not faithless. So spare her. I don't know if I can have a faithful Leliana at this point, though. Because she's hardened. But again, I don't think Talon would necessarily want to kill her. I think she's almost beneath our notice at this point, to be honest. Straw poll? Did you make one? Does that work? Oh, shoot. Holy crap, you guys are murderers. Wow. It's 75% of people are saying to kill her. Spared, she might live or die. We don't know. Lemonsy, you make good arguments. Okay, I think, to be honest, I am curious to see if I can spare her and... I am interested to see if I can actually kind of throw it up in the air. I'm gonna spare her, guys. I know you guys, the straw poll was really cool, but I think I am gonna spare her first and see what happens. I feel like it'll be more of a 50-50 shot, you know what I mean? And besides, I feel like it's almost like for Talon, it's like it's beneath our notice now to kill her, but let's see.
Release her, Leliana. She's no threat.
The Grand Cleric.
She is one woman. We are the Inquisition.
Exactly.
The Inquisitor has spoken.
Woo!
Run, tell your mistress that she has a choice. The Inquisition is coming.
Oh! What? She lived! Whoa!
No! This can't be it. There's nothing here.
Stonesmith, yeah, no, I thought I did too. Every action I've taken, I thought I was intentionally hardening her. Whereas before, well, I guess, you know what? I think at the very beginning, actually, with Talon, I think I actually decided, did I actually decide to spare the spy? I think I did. I think that's what's messed this up. I did not... Leliana is softer again. Wow. This'll be interesting. I thought she was hardened. Okay, this changes things. Interesting.
It's not what you expected. That Doesn't mean it's nothing.
Exactly.
The message carved in the lid. The left hand should.
I haven't seen this then. Let's see how this goes.
She's releasing me. The divine has a long reach, but it is always her left hand that stretches out. A thousand lies, a thousand deaths. Her commands, but my conscience that bore the consequences.
Okay. No, Leliana for Death Divine 2016. Yeah, that's actually what I was kind of thinking was gonna happen. But I liked what Talon said, that like, what is, you know, this is one woman, like, she's no threat to us, you know? Like, I liked that. See, Kayuk, I don't know, the killing the traitor, I'm not really sure, I'm not really sure if Talon would rather have killed her to cut off a loose end, or what, but I'll see this one through, and I might go back and change it, I don't know, but we'll see how it goes.
She apologized in the Fade. She said she failed you. This is what she meant.
All this time, Talon is not without mercy, too.
She was using me, just like I'd been used in the past. But Marjolaine's games were trifles. Justinia gambled with the fate of nations. She needed me. No one else could have done what I did. She knows that.
Then you have to let it go. Let her go. You don't owe her anything anymore.
If it were not for you, I would have killed Natalie and called it a good thing. Thank you for showing me what was right when I couldn't see it for myself. There are things that must be said, but not here. I will see you back at Skyhold.
So she's still capable of doing what is necessary, but she's not doing it with a cold heart. She still remembers compassion. Okay. They're all threats. Kill them all. Ha. Enlightened Leliana makes the best divine in your opinion. Lemonsy, yes. She tries diplomacy, then blood. And from what I've seen, I actually watched my friend play a little bit of Trespasser. She had a softened Leliana. And, it was sort of the same thing where, like, with the hardened Leliana, like, the halls ran with blood. You know what I mean? And it actually almost said basically the same thing with hers, that she, like, Leliana tried to speak to the people or whatever, and when that didn't work, the hall still ran with blood. You know what I mean? So, I honestly was a bit put out that it wasn't as much of an impact as I thought it would be. But, I mean, we'll see. We'll see how this goes. I was kind of looking forward to having a hardened Leliana with with Talon, but at the same time, Talon isn't a jerk and he's not merciless. Like, he's just straightforward. He's just, like, he just gets things done, you know? So, I've been trying to walk a fine line with Talon, not being a jerk, but not being too lovey-dovey either. Kayuk, you hurt me and mine, you die. See, and I totally am 100%, I like that option too. Like, I would definitely do that myself. I feel like that's a very valid way to go, and one that I would not be opposed to doing. Especially with Talon. Because I feel like for Dalish elves, especially, they're very clan-oriented, and for the Lavellans in Inquisition, I feel like the Inquisition sort of becomes the clan, and if you mess with the Inquisition, you mess with the clan.
The ambassador's support for the Inquisition.
Ah, Natalie is as persuasive as ever.
Okay, alright, so that was good. That sounded good.
I'm told that Ambassador Montillier is pleased with the restraint you showed in.
She's positively beside herself. I will never hear the end of it. Niceness before knives, Leliana. Haven't I always told you?
Will that be all, my lady?
For now.
He's like, excuse me, let me just leave now. I know, right? Top marks for Josie and pressure for Leliana. Yep, that's what I was thinking. Ah, new friends. Should we be snarky? Let's be snarky.
I love making new friends, don't you?
It was a gamble, Inquisitor. But it paid off. If you hadn't been with me at Valence, I would have killed Natalie. I'd have told you that I didn't have a choice. But there is always a choice.
It's true.
I am more than this. I am more than what Justinia made me.
Interesting. This is new for me. This is new. Cassandra is fantastic at impressions. Oh, it doesn't say that if you have an enlightened divine lady. Oh, okay, I see what you're saying. So, like, yeah, yeah. I guess it says something. It says something about, like, you know, how stuff still goes on behind the scenes, but.
Do you resent Justinia for what she did?
How can I when there is so much between us? When she gave her life for peace? No, I believe her intentions were pure. Most intentions are.
It's true. Most intentions at least think they're pure.
What does this mean for my Inquisition? Will you still be my spymaster?
Of course. I would not give up my post. Not after everything we've built. I just know now that I shouldn't ignore my heart. Mercy is not always a weakness.
Interesting. This is really interesting. You were a daily shelf in Origins. And the wardens became your kind. Exactly, Kaiyuk. My next Origins character is going to be a Dalish elf. And that's basically... She's going to be... My first warden was a mage. She was really beholden to nobody. She was scientifically curious about, like, everything. And, like, she was kind of socially awkward. Not, like, awkward, like, cutesy awkward. But, like, really quiet and reserved. You know? And, But, like, she became friends. You know, she got her friends or group of friends or whatever. But my Dalish elf is going to be hiding a lot of her pain about Tamlin's death behind a mask of, like, snarkiness and like, not, like, snarky sarcasm, but, like, humor. And anybody, as soon as they mess with anybody, Marjolaine, gonna die. You know, like, I mean, anybody messes with her people, they're gonna see the backside. Like, they're gonna see, like, the dark side of my warden, you know what I mean? Did this monologue help? What?
Does saying all this out loud make you feel any different?
Yes, actually. Giving the thought a voice forces me to admit what Justinia did to me.
Talking does make things a lot better in some ways.
I really am, before spymaster, left hand, or bard. I almost lost myself.
Interesting. Interesting. I do like this one. I do like that one. That's very interesting. This is really cool with Leliana, though. Before, she terrified me. You know? But I feel like it's also a good... Because I feel like Leliana and Talon have a lot of parallels. And I think this might be a good reminder for Talon to not get too hardened. You know? To remember that mercy is not a weakness. You know? To remember that lives... Every life is important in its own way. You know?
Inquisitor?
Anything I should know?
There is upheaval in L.A. Our support of Ambassador...
Hee-hee!
...scandalized...
Oh my...
If Orlais in turmoil, they will look to us for stability.
I like it.
Anything I should know?
Having the Templars join the Inquisition has done wonders for
us. True.
The people trust the Templars, and now
they love us.
Having the Templars.
Yep. Okay.
The people trust the Templars.
I'll leave you.
Interesting. Okay. Now we should do Blackwalls. Well, about Loghain. I wished that my first warden had let him live, because I don't know if my second warden will be able to let him live. And that was my biggest regret in Origins, was letting Alistair talk me out of letting Loghain redeem himself. Maybe we should go rescue Blackwall now. Well, I guess we haven't really gotten it yet. I kind of want to do Josephine's and then do Blackwall's. Let's do that with Stone. I think it was a Stonesmith earlier. Let's let Blackwall sit in this jail cell for a bit and stew about what he's done.
But the quartermaster is expecting.
Stop following
back.
Me.
You'll I have any requests and the associated bill when it is
I just,
that's
I don't
not
know
what
to do.
He meant.
I am well
pain
aware of
hides behind certainty, not knowing
searching is a first step.
Oh, you should. No, it's fine. Friggin'. What's up? Why is Blackwall gone?
The spymaster has confirmed it. Blackwall is gone.
Find him.
Track him down. He's needed here.
Sister Leliana had us search the Warden's quarters. Not much to find, except this. It was missing from last week's reports. I don't know what Blackwall's interest in this particular matter is.
This man is handsome.
A good place to start.
Who are you, dude? Lieutenant Cyril Mornay.
I should look around.
Yes, you should. Look at this big old fat note taped to this griffin. Inquisitor, you've been a friend and an inspiration. You've given me the wisdom to know right from wrong, and more importantly, the courage to uphold the former. It has been my honor to serve you. I feel like... Black, again, talking about like men who have done horrible things that can't be forgiven, but want to earn redemption. I feel like the right to earn redemption, if it's truly felt, should be allowed, you know? It's easy to die. Like, it's easy to just die for your mistakes. It's much harder to live and try to spend every day trying to make up for what you did, even though you can never make up for what you did, but to try to make it right. Okay, here's another spot where it dropped out. I apologize for that. I was in the middle of waxing eloquent on Blackwall. Apparently my game doesn't like, my recording doesn't like Blackwall. Every time he's like brought up, it's a problem. But what I was saying basically is that not that dying is an easy way out or, you know, is a good thing or a bad thing necessarily, but that it's like an eye for an eye, right? People are like, oh, you know, if you die, you know, you killed somebody, then you should die. And it's like, well, that's not going to bring the person back or the people back, especially if Blackwall killed more than one person. Like, if you want to do it like that, his one death isn't going to change the fact that it happened. And it could be like, you know, like, oh, well, justice. I'm like, well, justice would be making him suffer for what he's done, I think. It's not like the scales type of justice. It's not like, well, one death is one death. Even then it wouldn't be right because he's, you know, one death does not equal like what, like 20 deaths that he at least was in charge of ordering. Who knows how many of them he actually killed himself with his own hands. But he, for me anyway, at least personally, I think that it's much harder to try to live to make the world a better place, even though you've done something horrible. It's what the Wardens are almost, like, basically, like, the underwritten rule of the Wardens is, like, if your life was crummy, come to us, and if you did something horrible, come to us, and you can spend the rest of your life trying to make the world a better place. You can't fix what you did in the past, aka, friggin' aka soulless, like, you know, you can't change the past, but what you can do is make the current world better. You can try every day and you can suffer with what you did and try to make the world a better place. And in that, you may find some sort of redemption. So that's all I was trying to say. If you think differently, that's totally like Hayuk and I were having kind of on different ends of the spectrum on this, not like horribly or anything, but it facilitates a great discussion. So if you guys feel differently, let me know. I won't try to change your mind. I really would be interested in seeing what you think about Blackwall. He's a very complicated character in a complicated situation, but some people may see it one way and some like, not the fact that some people might be like, no, it's this way, you know, that this is how it is. But the fact that, like, people can say, it's this way, and then people can be like, no, it's this, this is how I see it. You know, the fact that different people can see it different ways, I think is freaking fantastic. So, anyway, let's get back to the rest of the videos. If there's, again, I don't mean to offend anybody with that opinion. If you are, let me know, and I will try to explain what I was saying, because I didn't mean that at all. So, anyway, we'll be right back in a second. I think we're gonna go... Let's go over to, If we lost some people, thank you for having been here when I upload this to YouTube. Thank you for coming for when you did. I appreciate it. I don't know how much longer this will be able to go on. I'd like to do Josephine's mission before I go. Let's see, what is this? Sure. All right, let's go be sad. And or see that he gets his comeuppance. Man, the detail in the PC version for Orlais is great.
For the murders of General Vincent Callier, Lady Laurette Callier, their four children, and their retainers, you are sentenced to be hanged from the neck until dead. Do you have anything to say in your defense? Very well.
He just looks so dead inside.
They're going to kill him.
Good grasp of the obvious, this one.
Ah! Oh my gosh, Dorian!
Proceed.
Ooh, you're right. Executioner has a really interesting mask.
A Grey Warden.
This man is innocent of the crimes laid before him. Orders were given, and he followed them like any good soldier.
So he's not innocent.
He should not die for that mistake.
Then find me the man who gave the order.
He still shed blood, you know what I mean?
Oh, shit.
Ah, Varric.
Blackwall! No, I am not Blackwall. I never was Blackwall. Warden Blackwall is dead, and has been for years. I assumed his name to hide like a coward from who I really am.
You, after all this time.
It's over. I'm done hiding. I gave the order. The crime is mine.
I do think it's an interesting touch that this is the only time it rains in Orlais. When we're in Valrio is when Tom Rainier is found. And Cole knew but didn't tell? Oh, I'm sure Cole did know, but he said something about like his head being really tangled. I don't know, but man, that was cool bringing Varric. I was kind of curious if Varric would say something. Cole even hints at it quite a bit. I do know that the Blackwall line, he says that he uses the name as a wall or something. I do remember that one, but. Dorian, that was funny. Usually they don't all three interact. I've brought Solas before, and he says, you know, human justice or something. But that was interesting, bringing Varric. Varric kind of picked up on it right before it happened.
Can you believe it? Tom Rainier himself.
Tom Rainier.
You must know something about Rainier.
For the massacre of a noble and his family.
And I liked Dorian's response, though. I'm like, don't talk to Cole like that. Oh, that was funny.
Where did they take the prisoner?
In the jail of the marketplace. If you've goodbyes to say, say them now.
I am the Inquisitor, man. I'll do what I want.
Lots of people can't wait to see that man.
I do not know if there will ever be a character I make who leaves Blackwall to die in here. I feel like redemption. Holy crap! I just realized I don't have my bow. Where's my bow? I feel like redemption is. I do have it, but where is it? It's not on my back. It's invisible. Whoop whoop.
That is concerning, yes.
Concerning? He's a butcher.
That's a Ferelden noble, though, right? Maybe not. It's got a mask. Like the dude, not the girl. Being sarcastic with Cole is such a waste. Cole is cute with everybody. I love bringing Cole and Solas out. They're great.
What do you think of the Inquisition now? Their fortunes have certainly changed.
Oh, is that Meriden?
Incentives for any merchant willing to make the trip.
Really? I never heard that.
Ah, interesting. Oh, yeah, that's right. And we've got the Josephine. Well, I should just pop right out and do Josephine's thing. I'm definitely not going to leave Blackwall in the prison. I'm definitely going to bring him back and let him go to the wardens. That's something I'm not interested. I'm not interested in seeing the other outcomes with Blackwall because I have great admiration and respect and love for Blackwall. Even before I romanced him, I was very close to him. I don't know. I liked him a lot immediately. I am interested to see how Talon will handle this, though.
I didn't take Blackwall's life. I traded his debt. He wanted me for the wardens.
Ambush. Lemonsy, I just saw your comment.
He was killed. I took his name to stop the world from losing a good man. But a good man. The man he was.
Above all, Blackwall is trying. He is trying to make up for what he did, even though he knows he can't, you know? Talon's so beautiful! Let me see. I ended up, at the very beginning of the stream, I actually did dye Dorian's armor back to a slightly more reasonable color combination. And I did take the flower crown off. Because I really wanted to see, I figured it was time for Dorian to be mature again. I don't know. I loved it the way it was. But like all good things must come to an end. Let's do this.
You think your death will make up for what you did?
Isn't it a start?
No! It's an end, you idiot! Let's go with that one.
That depends on what you say.
Don't you understand? I gave the order to kill Lord Callier, his entourage, and I lied to my men about what they were doing. When it came to light, I ran. Those men, my men, paid for my treason while I was pretending to be a better man.
I'm a little bit weirded out that the Inquisitor backs up from that.
A murderer, a traitor, a monster.
But he carves toys for children, you know? He's not a monster. I've seen monsters. He's done horrible things. He's done monstrous things. But he's trying, in his own way, he's trying to make up for that. We were talking earlier, I totally understand that why people don't like Blackwall and why they think he deserves death. I get that. I do. But at the same time, I find redemption an interesting concept and one that is usually the better route to take. But, I mean, that's not saying that you think it's the better route to take or that anybody thinks it's the better route to take. It's just, you know, you're good at, like, you know, checking out all the options, you know? And, I mean, someday maybe I'll make a character who leaves him to die. In many ways, he does deserve to die, because he's alive when others are dead that he killed. But at the same time, I think death is just an easy, cheap way to, like, aka, like, sort of make up for it, but it's not. Like, it's easy enough to die. It's harder to live with your mistakes every day and try to make recompense for them. Make him wear the plaid. Yeah, we'll give him plaid weave and the flower crown. Hey, Barrett Green! What's up? Welcome, once more. I remember, you've been here before. Welcome, welcome. He's not a monster, Kayuk, but he should have atoned when he realized what he's doing is wrong and not hide behind his eyes. But it took him a long time to figure that out. Like, he was being cowardly and hiding, like, in many ways. Like, he wasn't just, like, trying... He was trying to use the name to hide himself, but I think he also wanted to be like Blackwall, and so he took his name, and at first it was just hiding, but then... You know, he stopped. It can't happen for some people, they might off the bat be like, oh, I did bad, you know? But I like that Blackwall's character is more complicated because it means that you know, it took him years to realize that this was what he needed to do, and that's a little bit more realistic than just like, whoa, like knowing exactly what to do right off the bat, I feel. But again, like, he's a complicated character, so.
Would a monster have given himself up? Somewhere along the line, you stopped pretending.
Exactly. Exactly. Don't you just try to be all sad about this?
Yes. Who were you before this mess?
I was a captain in the Orlesian army.
Lemon's Italian has some great eyebrows? Thank you! He did. Caillou, I would agree. He did delude himself by taking Blackwall's name. But he's now learning. He's becoming better. It gave him by deluding himself and perhaps running away in cowardice, it did give him the opportunity to change. I feel. And I'm totally playing, you know, devil's advocate to your position. I totally think whatever I like. There's multiple ways to take a stance on Blackwall's situation.
Know about Blackwall, the real Blackwall.
We met in a tavern when I was on the run. I was nothing, a waste of life, but he wanted to recruit me. We headed to Val Chavan for the joining. The Blackwall insisted on making a stop.
Am I hyped for Andromeda Beret Green? You have no idea. Like, I didn't realize until today that it's about 4 months away, and I can't freaking wait. Can't freaking wait. If you rescue Blackwall, his end screen tiles are always inspired. They are. I think Blackwall's redemption is a very inspiring one. Like, yeah, I like that you said it that way.
Not saying I disagree, but Blackwall clearly thought you were worth saving.
No one should have died for me. He would have wanted me to carry.
And that's where he made another mistake, was not carrying on to Val Chavan. So it was cowardly, in a way, to run away and hide under Blackwall's name. But there was a part of him here, like exactly like he said. There was a part of him that wanted to be better. Your crime.
I need to know the details of what you did, who you killed, why.
I think that's a good point, Kaiyuk. He's a part of this family, and only family should take him out. So you wouldn't leave his death to somebody else. You would take it upon yourself. And that I think, if he has to die, if Blackwall has to die, that's the way to do it. It's not somebody else's problem. It's our problem. You know.
Time Sir Robert's involvement was uncovered. I was long gone. Of course, the Grand Duke disavowed any knowledge of the act and publicly condemned it. Robert killed himself. Poison in his wine. Another victim of the great game.
My reports say that Callier was with his family.
The thing is,
you had them all slaughtered.
I don't think Blackwall was actually there. I think he sent his men out to kill them without going himself, which is another strike against him, I think.
They thought they were defending their country. No one likes to think about that. But it's names that carry power in this world. Bloodlines.
Oh, like in the movies when people want a redemption? Oh, Kaiyuk! Okay, I see what you say. I see what you're saying there. I like you give him a hug, forgive him, and then kill him, like let him have his death. I see. I do. While those ends are always tragic, I do like those, you know, in a way. Like if it fits the story, I do like that. If like, especially if the person is asking for death, but also for like if they need or want forgiveness, I think that's a good way to do it. Let's be stern.
Only cowards strike the defenseless.
I've been on enough battlefields to know the same crime at the right time would have earned a medal. that's what I did, and why I deserve to be here.
You got your men to help you. What did you tell them?
They didn't know who they were attacking. I told them it was an important mission.
I'm not sure how he got their trust so implicitly. He must have been a good man and then gone down a bad path, but his men didn't notice. They only knew the good man from the beginning.
I'm not forcing my men to commit crimes.
I cannot argue with that.
There's another thing I'm still wondering.
Yes.
Cole suggests he was there, I think, that he found out as it was happening but couldn't tell his men to stop. Oh, okay. When does Cole say that? That would be interesting to hear. There's so many people I wish I could bring Cole out with, but especially playing as a rogue, I can't bring him out.
That's all for now.
Because otherwise, we just get murderized.
I have Liliana's report on Tom Rainier.
Summarize it.
Give me the overview. Looks like our friend was once a respected captain in the Imperial Orlesian army. Before the civil war, he was turned, persuaded to assassinate one of Selene's biggest supporters. He led a group of fiercely loyal men on this mission and told them nothing of it.
So he did lead a group. Okay.
A few lucky ones like Mornay managed to escape.
I don't really want to be that harsh, but
let me guess. Our spymaster had this lying around somewhere, didn't she?
It would have been difficult for anyone to connect Blackwall to Rainier.
Yeah, somehow.
Even Liliana has something of a blind spot when it comes to...
It's true. Liliana's only human.
What do we do now?
And she was very attached to the Wardens.
Rainier has accepted his fate, but you don't have to. We have resources. If he's released to us, you may pass judgment on him yourself.
If it were up to you, what would happen?
What he did to the men under his command was unacceptable. He betrayed their trust, betrayed ours. I despise him for it. And yet he fought as a warden, joined the Inquisition, gave his blood for our cause. And the moment he shakes off his past, he turns around and owns up to it. Why?
Some part of you is impressed by what he did, isn't it?
Saving Mornay the way he did took courage. I'll give him that. But I can't tell you what to do.
Can't decide yet.
I need to think about it.
Do what you must, but come to a decision soon. This will not wait forever.
Pretty dragons. Or no, those are wyverns. Alright, here's my sort of outro added in thing. So I just wanted to say I thank you guys very much for watching. I hope you're enjoying. And after this point, I know it's kind of a cliffhanger, right? We just dealt with Blackwall and he's still in the jail. After this, we go do Josephine's mission. And that stuff I haven't even looked at yet, but I do know that we're going to go do Josephine's after this. Kind of do what we said earlier and let Blackwall kind of sit and stew and think about things. Because while Erica was like... on top of getting him out, Talon and Blackwall aren't as close. They're still, they're friends and stuff, and Talon recognizes what Blackwall, at least when he was a warden, understood what Blackwall represented and respected him greatly, even though we don't bring him out a lot. He still respected him and his the fact that he's a warden and everything. Because in my head, my Dalish elf, Lynn, is the warden with Talon. So someday I'll have to play like that. But yeah, anyway, thank you guys for watching. I hope you're enjoying so far. And I will see you in the next one.